There's also, did you see the other one I have? Take a look at those.
I thought those were taken.
Well, they were, one of them was gonna be for mom, but she got it. She's got one.
So that one might be a good one for you.
Yeah, that's got a small neck on it.
So there's two of them. So, and when you select them, remember you're gonna be one with your Ipu.
Can I borrow your power over here a little bit there?
Yeah, so Gloria, is this a good one for the bottom?
Yeah, let's take a look at what the styles. It doesn't matter if the bottoms are flat. A lot of people like it flat because you wanna be able to, you know, set it like that. But it does not necessarily mean that you need to have that. And what this one that you made, this one, the first time, this is the first one that she made. I love this size that she has because it's very portable. You can put like in one of those Ipu holders in the back of you, and you can walk around. It's really, I love this size. I want to make one this size. Okay.
Yeah. Huh?
Once.
This is one where we cut the top off, and then this one will fit. You cut two off of this one, and it fits over the top. And you have to line. I've marked the little lines where you mark it up to line it up. So this one fits like that. When it'll be done, it'll look like that.
And that won't stand up there.
This one will not stand up right because it's not completely flat. It's almost, but not just a little bit. Yeah.
So hers doesn't have to, because a lot of times, a lot of Ipus are like on the side.
Yeah.
But and it's not necessary. It's, the importance isn't whether it lays flat.
Yeah.
The importance is where it sounds, how it sounds. Okay. So that's what is more important is that.
This one has a really good sound.
So what you want to do, there's a couple of things. So if you want something that you can cut the top off, any of the tops that are like the round ones like this will make excellent tops. Okay, so that's what you want to look for. You do every Ipu gourd, we need to take a look because some might be cracked. We checked every single one of them, and I didn't see any cracks on any of them. If there are any cracks, then that farm will replace them, which is really
nice.
Great.
I have a second top that the bottom, by the time I got it home, was cracked. So I hope that back.
The process of making your Ipu, the first thing we want to do is, since we've got pictures, it would be great that once you've selected yours, then we'll hold them up so we can see what they look like from the beginning, the before and after, okay? So once you find yours, you need two for the top and the bottom. Once you find them, then you'll need to take it over there, fill up your water, your bucket with water, and any sponge, you're gonna just wash it down, clean it down, okay?
I heard that.
Yeah, just really look at it to make sure. And you'll see it when you're washing it. There's not any cracks. And it doesn't matter if they've got some characters.
Oh, yeah.
You know, if they've got some little mold or any of that kind of stuff, like this one here, which she's got. If you notice, it looks like it's moldy. When you finish it up and clean it up, it's really pretty.
Moldy.
Yeah, but it'll be beautiful.
Mine is, but actually,
because we're gonna sand it down.
Well, I like mine with all the mold. I think it looks cool.
And some people like it with all the little warts and all that. So it makes
like
part
warts.
Of the character.
Yeah.
Like
there's
warts?
A song called Warts and All. Yeah.
Warts and All.
So which this is gonna be your bottom?
I don't know. Jenny said.
I think you
should.
It's got good sound.
So if this is your bottom.
So I have to get a small top, or does it matter? Same size?
No. Now we just have to figure out. When you fit it on here, it just has to be able, whatever you cut on the top.
Yeah. No, I understand.
This has
that.
To be able to fit on top of it.
Yeah, no.
We can make that work.
I'm watching the dust fly off.
Oh, I know. I wear my really old clothes, so.
Right.
Yes, I changed out of my white shorts and my cut off.
Yeah.
Because you're gonna hit it on the side.
No, I'm just looking for a smaller.
This one seems so big.
You want to work with something that feels comfortable with, you know, with
yeah.
This is not something you're doing forever.
Oh, no.
You know what I mean? So I like this one. What are you going to use for a top to go with it? You want to try to match the coloring as much as you can. Okay, now remember this one's got a different.
Are you ready to start cleaning? Yeah.
And look at the coloring on it. Do you think it might, if you have it in the sun, look at it.
Do you have anything you want to suffer?
No.
So where did you put my other one?
Yeah, that looks really similar.
Okay, and what do you think?
And then use the kitchen one to...
I think it looks kind of good on top.
Put away.
The little skinny thing that they put on top.
I think that would be just fine.
Whatever.
Yeah, I heard you.
Hard to decide, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I'm just waiting to see what...
They're gonna be different. Your voice is a little bit lower, isn't it?
Yeah.
That one sounded more deep.
Yeah.
Try A-N-O, chant one. I like that one for you.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
Perfect.
No, I just figured we could share.
Okay, here's my brush.
Hey, how are you? Good.
I'm filthy already. Oh, okay.
So this is what it ultimately looks like. So you'll need to have one that goes in on top of the other one. So the bottom has to have enough of a neck that the top can sit on top of it. Okay, so Andre has hers right over here, so you can see her process of what she's done. So she took...
And she's making
an Ipu Heke. So that's why you need to get the how it's going to look. Okay, because we have to do the top and the bottom. Okay, and this you want to make sure that whenever you decide, the top has to be able to come down onto it.
Okay. So the bottom of the top is going to be...
Yep.
I'm good. Thank you.
How are you guys doing?
I just let it soak a little bit. Wonderful. You don't have to stretch much, you know. Just let it soak.
Okay.
And take it out.
There it is.
How are you doing there, Missy?
Good. It was bright green when it came here.
Oh, yeah?
No, it's brown. Water.
And now it's dirty.
Okay.
Well, these things, you're just, you know, when you're doing this, this is the kind of thing that when you're starting to work with your things, you can start to ask for its blessing, that it's going to have some nice sounds for you. And this is where you get to connect and bond with your ipus.
I'm using this sponge to set my brush or my thing on.
Look at that, it's coming out
almost the same color
color. Mm-hmm.
Looking at it like this.
It'd be really fun to go to the gorge farm.
Isn't that beautiful?
Isn't that gorgeous? I love that. That's really close to hers, and hers was select to make it that pretty.
Now, which one is that going to be?
That's my
single.
Ipu Heke Ole.
Just a little one.
Yours is good
for me to hold. I mean, you know, and the sound is so good, I don't mind.
Remember, you're not going to be holding it at that top.
No, that's the one.
That's when you're going to be.
Yeah. But I had to get a smaller
one. And most of the people, when they're using theirs, is it necessarily is when they have the cording?
Yeah.
Like I wrap my cording around my hand.
Mm-hmm.
Well. So do you hang on to the just pretty much the cord that you're hanging
on? No, I hold on to the
around the neck too.
Let me show you how I do that.
I wrap my hand in it.
Yeah.
So I've got my hand around it, but the cord is really tight on my wrist. Mm-hmm. So when I have to go and undo it, it's like.
So here is Andre's, and when I use Andre's, I just put my hand inside the cord and I wrap it like that.
That's the same thing I do.
So yeah. rather than, I mean, I still have my hand on it.
Thinking?
but I'm not, mine is like this. Mine is really big. Then I have to really wrap it twice so that I am, but otherwise in hers, on Andre's, I have my thumb.
That's the same thing I do. So you're just holding it like that. It's not trying to get around the neck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Most of them are too fat to do that.
Yep. And so, but you don't want to have them so small that you can't get the sound. So that's the reason why oftentimes people will just make sure that this is somewhat in proportion, but it's not really the proportion. I mean, it's kind of a fine line of the appearance, but also get the sound that you want.
It's small, but it's got a really good sound. Yeah.
And wherever you're going to be playing on your Ipu, it has a different sound on all of it.
Yeah, I was going around it.
And you won't have your final sound until you have it cleaned and assembled, because this echo chamber will make another sound yet again.
And bring food.
And this way, there's some kids that can
This is going to be neat. You can name your own, you know. Did you cut hers already?
Already.
Oh.
Look at that.
Hi, Amber.
You should sell Ipu noses.
I know. Wouldn't that be cool? She's got good ideas, by the way.
Hey, maybe for Halloween.
Here we go.
Or a nose.
You okay?
Yep.
Okay, cool. And now we're going to have to clean that bugger out. Now.
Sure.
Yeah. Andre has that little spoon over there. You do this.
Okay.
That's it's also yours. A little bowl.
You have to clean yours out now.
You can make your soup or whatever. What's happening is, Ipu Heke is an instrument that's been around for many, many years. And what we're doing today is Kumu, Gloria Nahalea, is showing some of her hamana, her students, how to make Ipu Hekes. And you see the process, it's a lot of work, but if you really want to have your own Ipu Heke, your own style, then you need to make your own. And then contact, Napua, Kumu, Halahula, or Napua Lani.
You want to be careful when you're doing that, honey, that you don't go right through the gourd. So what you want to do with that is just kind of, where's that, nothing fits in this, is it? It's just going to take a little while for this one to.
Yeah, Kapuna, she knows what she's doing, she got it.
You might have to just see that little fork thing up right there. Yeah, are you?
Yeah, look, what?
Okay, what on these? Sometimes they have seeds, like all those are seeds. You want to hang on to those. Because you can grow them. That's all
about 8 or 12? Are those all seeds?
All those are the seeds.
Oh, wow.
These are all the seeds right here.
Somebody can have all my seeds because we don't have space to grow. All we have is a tiny house.
Yeah. Yeah, so you can save the seeds. I mean, I think it's a cool thing.
There are so many seeds here. That works well.
Okay. Do that. And then with this, it might be helpful to get some of this. Off so that you can get more room in that. Okay, so that you just want to kind of.
Gosh, my neck is really clean and smooth already.
Yep. So that's what you want to do, is just kind of get this part.
You got a good gourd, it was really clean in the beginning, and it has a really clean back and all that stuff.
Yeah, because
so now I've got the pin. You need to decide how far down you're going
to
be.
I don't know how far it needs to go. This will be here. So
you know that there's not going to be much of a sound out of this.
Isn't there? This one has incredible sound.
But it'll be perfect for you.
for me to hold, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
because
I'm
that's what you're thinking of doing? Okay.
Yeah. If I...
See, this has to fit into...
I know that. Over here. It, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It fits down on.
On.
So this can be cut clear up to here.
You want at least an inch of where this is going
to
be.
So this could cut clear up to here then.
Okay, that's where you want it?
I would think so.
Okay, I'm going to sit down.
Yeah, why don't you park your carcass?
I'll park my carcass. So you want it, it's going to stick up like this, right?
I'm taking this at the narrow one. I don't know, it could be cut clear up to here and sit down on it.
You know, we probably should do this one first.
Okay.
So you know where it's going to be fitting. Okay, so if it's going to
fit. Oh, and we could just set it down on top of here and find out where to put it.
Yeah. So let's just hold this like this, and let's just see where this is gonna fit into. Then you'll know how much you're gonna cut on here. Unless we just start off here.
I think it would be up in that.
Okay. Because you want it, you don't want it too narrow.
I'm the cutter.
Oh, see, that goes down to where I said. Now.
Isn't that where you wanted it?
Yeah.
That's why I said something was stuck on there to do that.
It's exactly where that line was.
That's the cutest little.
I think it's cute.
Very, very cute.
Okay, because now when we do that, then we have to do the top.
You
can't have too big of a hole at the top. No, so Bill can actually cut that for you
right
now.
There.
At the spot that you wanted.
Which is Ziploc, okay?
We're not going to mention where this is being held at, but we're at the Bellevue, right on the golf course here. Beautiful place. We're having the ladies of Halau Hula Ona Pualani making their own Ipu Heke. You can see more of that later. You learn to have safety when you're cutting, because luckily I didn't cut my thumb off. But when you're using a blade, make sure you cut real soft and watch your fingers. Not good if you think you're Hawaiian.
Looks challenging.
Well, Chris has been with us a long time, and she's done many of these Ipu Hekes, right?
No.
Okay, good.
This is the first time. Yeah. I thought it was about time.
Yeah, but she loves the culture a lot. So what we're doing is we're drilling the holes in here to make it easier, because it's in a different angle. So we put the drill holes in here, and then we take the hex saw and we cut around it. So by making the holes in here, it gets the hex saw inside easier to cut around. You can make a hole. Otherwise, it'll be really hard. So again, if you're using a hacksaw, make sure you don't. Make sure you watch yourself. You know what I mean? Use safety. So what we're doing again is we're making drill holes here, and then getting the hacksaw in between here, and then we're gonna file this all down, and make it easy, and make it round. Because, yeah.
Come on, get out.
Right. That's okay. Yeah.
It's so cute. Okay. So now all we gotta do from where we're at now, where you're at, is we just take the sanding paper. And when it's yours done, as the sanding paper, we clean that out. I mean, we just sand it down so it's nice and smooth.
You gotta cut the other one, right? Oh no.
And then after that, we put on a little oil, and you're done. You're going to start sanding up in the top like this, and you're going to start sanding all the way around it. I think you get all the little warts and stuff, all the little bumps and stuff. So you want to just sand it down so it's nice and smooth. Okay, we're using this is a smoothing one, and then we use a finishing one to make it really nice and smooth, okay? So that's what you're going to do now. You're going to go over...
Over there in the edge again.
Yeah.
Really
okay.
Nice. Yeah. For people to get there, and I have on my corner lot.
Okay. Do you need to have sanding paper?
I have it at home.
Okay.
I'm not gonna do it now.
So you don't want to glue it together and.
You want me to glue it together? I'll glue it together and sand it now.
Okay. No, you don't have to. You can do it later on.
I have to do it now.
Okay.
Oh, there you go.
Okay. Now what you need to do is you're going to pick out the white part.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow, look at that.
Put it inside the
sketch. Sweet.
Well, actually, Auntie Andre and Kumu did the first.
It's going to make a little.
And I asked her if she was a doubt, but she said no, and I realized she wasn't because the following.
I forgot to get something to
yeah, so we were at the
tie around this, but just kind of twist it. And then you're just going to kind of
smash it.
Smash it a little bit.
With the outdoor hammer is vital.
So you see how it's getting kind of oily there? And then you're just going to rub that on your... Just rub it around. And if you need another one, grab another one. Okay, but that's probably going to go pretty far. Just get you a little bit of... Then you can always add some more of the other oil later to kind of...
Isn't that cool? You did it from a kukui? Natural kukui? The kukui nut. Kukui. K-U-K-U-R.
Okay.
And this is going to cool.
I can't believe I started out with that weird, raw, moldy, dirty glory.
I mean, because this will actually, if this is gone, imagine that, this will actually go down a little bit deeper.